this was a hard fought race, but it's over now. So if you would, let me tell you a story. It's a story of a little boy and a big city. Nearly 50 years ago, this little boy came to the city from another land. And the people of this city, warm and kind and loving, welcomed this boy, nurtured him, taught him right from wrong, gave him opportunities he could not have imagined. This city and its people have welcomed children from other lands, just like this little boy. For nearly 200 years, the city is Chicago, the people are each and every one of you, and that little boy, now all grown up with kids and grandkids of his own, stands before you tonight, humbly and gratefully, as a candidate for mayor. Chicago have made me who I am today. We may have missed by a little, but you put me here tonight. And I, all of you, and I will not forget you. Tonight, I have something to say to the next generation, to all the little boys and girls watching. We didn't lose today, we tried today. For what we believed in. You don't succeed at this or anything else unless you try. So keep trying, keep standing up for yourselves and what you believe in, and someday one of you will be standing right here where I am tonight. Thousands of people from all over this great city came together. People from the north side, from the south side, from the southeast side, and the northwest side, and the southwest side. People, every color, every creed, people who speak every language on the face of this earth. People, good, hardworking people came together and spoke with one clear voice to say, you want to be heard. A government that works for you. You want a city that works for everyone, and I mean everyone. Not just for downtown or for the neighborhood, but for both. We've got some big problems in Chicago, and no matter who is mayor, we've got to work together to solve them. In the last 15 years, Chicago has lost over 200,000 people. They just up and left. You can't have a thriving city if everybody's leaving. Yes, we have a debt crisis and a pension crisis, but that's because of the one thing. We have a growth crisis in Chicago. Long term, Chicago can't solve its problems unless it grows. That means people moving here, not leaving here. That means a growing middle class, not a shrinking one. We can't tax our way out of this crisis. We can't keep borrowing our way out of this crisis. We can only grow our way out of this crisis. There are too many shootings on our streets, too much violence in our neighborhoods. To grow, to keep people in our city, to attract new people, we need to end the violence, and I mean end it. Yeah. Ending the violence isn't just the right thing to do, it's the smart thing to do. We need to stop the waves and waves of school closings and privatization schemes. To grow and keep our young families, we need to do better than improve our schools. We need to make them a model for the nation. Making our schools a model for the nation isn't just the right thing to do, it's the smart thing to do. We need to stop paying too much attention to what happens downtown and too little attention to our neighborhood. To really grow, we need to invest in our neighborhoods, help small neighborhood businesses, and create jobs for people in our neighborhoods. Things aren't just the right things to do, they're the smart things to do. A less violent city is a more attractive city. A city with great schools is a more attractive city. A city with thriving neighborhoods is a more attractive city. And you know what? A more attractive city will grow. It will have a growing middle class. It will prosper. And a prosperous, growing city won't have a pile of bills that it cannot pay. And a pile of forgotten people it can't care for. And that's the Chicago tens of thousands of people voted today. That's who they voted for today. Chicago, where everyone has a voice and where our leaders really listen. A Chicago people want to move to, not run away from. A Chicago that works for you, not just a few. We may have fallen short of votes today, but we will make sure these people's voices are heard. We will not stop fighting for people. Not today, not tomorrow, not ever. I'd like to thank especially my campaign team, the SEIU Healthcare Illinois Indiana, SEIU Local 1, State Council, the Chicago Teachers Union, and its courageous president, Karen Lewis. I want to thank the Amalgamated Transit Union Locals 241 and 308. The American Federation of Teachers, Chicago ACTS, the Chicago Fire Department, paramedics and EMS professionals, Texas Pacific, the Forest, the Coalition of Black Trade Unionists, the Communication Workers of America, District 4, the Cook County College Teachers Union, Local 1600, of Teachers, the Illinois Education Association, National Nurses United, Teamsters Local 743 and 705, the United Electrical Workers, the United Steelworkers District 7, United Working Families, Workers United, Congressman Danny Davis, Cook County Commissioners, my colleagues, see them all at work, Richard Boykin, Robert Steele, Stan Moore, and Luis Arroyo Jr. I also want to salute former Cook County Board President Bobby Steele, my finance chair, the inimitable David Schaefer and Mari Castro, Dolores Huerta, Gloria Steinem, New York Mayor Ross Baraka, Dr. Willie Wilson, the Reverend Jesse Jackson, from the west side. Reverend Marshall Hatch, my neighbor from the west side. Move on. Democracy for America and Governor Howard Dean. Reclaim Chicago. Senator Nelson, Illinois. The Arab American Democratic Club. Working Families Party. Grassroots Illinois Action. And last but not least, the Indo-American Democratic Organization. Brothers and sisters, all assembled here tonight, we engage in a wonderful struggle to restore democracy in the city of Chicago, and so proud of all the support that you have given my candidacy. Thank you so much. We move on. Let's continue to fight for democracy.
Yo soy un chico.